friends, and welcome to the Gabala Shooting Club here in the finals hall, where we're all pumped up for the 50-meter rifle three-position swimming event. I'm Hilary Russell, and I am more than pleased to have Australia's 2008 Olympic Games bronze medalist, Warren Potten, here with me today. Welcome, Warren, and thank you so much for joining us today.
Oh, thank you for inviting me.
Well, it's been kind of a crazy morning, to say the least. Normally, the qualifications take place in the qualifications hall and not in the finals hall.
Normally it would, but the fog was that thick this morning, they couldn't see the targets.
Can you imagine that? It's a real problem. You know, we have the 50-meter pistol event later going on later on. It was also to take place this morning. But if you can't see the targets, then what are you supposed to do? We also have the Skeet Woman event going on, and they are doing the qualifications and stopping for a couple of minutes as the fog moves across the field of play. So it's really kind of a problem today.
It certainly is. The weather, yeah, and been bitterly cold as well. So I'm sort of glad it's been moved inside.
I am sure. These guys must be really, a woman must be really happy to be back inside, because it is bitterly cold, like you said. You know, 2 days ago, I was walking around with just a button-down shirt and pants and very comfortable, and then all of a sudden the weather changed on a dime, which I don't think is easy for anybody who's shooting outdoors.
No, it's true, because as you're saying, the weather's been 20, 23 degrees, been lovely, and then suddenly it gets cold, and yeah, you've got to change your whole outlook of how you're going to compete.
Exactly. So let's just go over what this final consists of. The top eight athletes after qualifications enter into the final after their qualification scores have been erased. So it's a fair game for anybody. Anybody can win this. We're going to start off in the kneeling position, and the women will be shooting at three series of five shots, in which they have 200 seconds per series to shoot. This is followed by a 7-minute break for the changeover in sighting time, and then we'll be moving it on over to the prone. At that point, we can go on and explain what will be going on after that. But after the kneeling position, you might think you know who is going to be going home with the gold medal, but it's such a long final. Where in the years before the new finals format, the final just took place in the standing position. Now they do all positions, which is great to see, and it's always a surprise. You know, yesterday during the men's event, I really thought that Brynn was going to be winning from Norway. He was going to be winning because during the kneeling and the prone position, he was holding on to first place.
He was, yeah. And
really
standing,
steadily.
He was overtaken, yeah.
Exactly. I mean, still, he finished off with a bronze medal, so that's better than nothing.
Yeah, true.
So, just for your viewers, just don't keep in mind that after the kneeling position, things can change around really fast. And you'll see that also when you get into the standing position, that things change on a dime. And you think you know who's going to be on the highest up of the podium, and then all of a sudden the last shot takes place and everything goes crazy.
This finals format's really made it exciting, where before someone had a bit of a lead going in the final, they tend to keep it over 10 shots, but this is a 45-shot final. And sometimes it changes position. Instead of said right down the last shot, you have no idea. Sometimes it's really exciting.
It really is. Now, obviously, Warren, you're here for the prone event, and you've been here for a little while, haven't you?
I've been a couple of days now, It's acclimatizing.
So let's just talk about the finals hall, this venue in general. What do you think about it?
Oh, it's a phenomenal venue. It's a lovely venue to see. Good quality. I think when the weather's fine outside, it'll be very good scores. Huge finals hall.
Yeah. It is beautiful. And everyone's commenting on the wood, you know, wood paneling that they have in here. And everyone's commenting and saying it gives it a real warm effect.
It does, yeah.
Yeah. It is really, really nice. And, you know, it'll be interesting just to find out what the scores will be in this final today. And we'll have a chance to introduce all eight finalists in just a second. Just to keep in mind, this is the cream of the crop. This is the best of the best that has been invited here. It's a real elite group of men and women and athletes that come here and to duel it out for the gold. It's the last event of the 2014 ISSF season, and it's a really important one.
Oh, it certainly is.
On firing point A, representing the People's Republic of China, we hardly even have to say who she is, it's Yi Siling.
Yeah, she's a very, very well-known person. She's extremely well on air rifle with another event, and doing very well in this event now. She's got a few medals this year, and as usual, not unusual to see her on the finals.
On firing point B, representing Germany, we have Beate Gauss.
Yeah, the current world champion from Granada just last month, and she's another one having a very good year.
On firing point C, representing Norway, we have got Malin Westerham.
Yeah, she has a bronze in the World Championships. She's her first podium position for some time, but she's been quite consistent through the years.
On firing point D, representing Italy, everybody knows her, it's Petra Zubelsing.
Very popular person, she's a lovely person. Yeah, she won the World Cup in Fort Benning. Always got a smile on her face and a very popular person.
There's her boyfriend, Niccolo Campriani.
Another well-known man.
On firing point E, representing the United States of America, we've got Amy Sowash.
Yes, another person been around for a long while now. She hasn't quite really struck through the big time, as in major medals, but yeah, she had a good year this year. It's good to see her on the finals.
On firing point F, representing Croatia, we have Svetlana Pejic.
Another very well-known person, very popular person, lovely person. And yeah, a silver medal at the World Championships, plus another good year.
And someone who I just think is a great person, but I always mess up her name. Poor thing.
Yes.
On firing point G, representing Germany, we've got Eva Ruskin.
Yeah, another one from a strong German team. She's always sort of been around up there, and another great year. Obviously, you know, she's got a gold at Maribor, so here representing Germany again.
And on firing point H, representing the People's Republic of China, we've got Cheng Jing.
Yeah, World Cup silver in Beijing this year, and he just hasn't been around very much at the moment, so someone we've got to look out for in the future, I guess.
And it's no surprise to have two women from the People's Republic of China in the final. I mean, they've got such an amazingly strong team, but we can say that also about the German team. They've got two of their finalists in today, so...
Two very strong nations.
Exactly. I mean, really, when you look at this list of finalists, the start list, it's amazing how much talent is in there. There are some women that haven't been around or don't have as much experience as the others, but, you know, let's come back down to that last shot to find out what's going to happen.
Yep. Yeah, if it's your day and a little bit of luck goes your way sometimes, walk away with a medal.
So once again, the women begin in the kneeling position and they shoot at three series of five shots in which they have 200 seconds per series to shoot. Warren, do you think that 200 seconds is enough time?
Free indoors, finals range, plenty of time.
Okay.
But outdoors, if the wind's mucking around, it could be running a bit short of time.
Okay.
But on average, I think it's enough time. Enough to give you a bit of pressure to get your shot away cleanly, but also... You don't want to get too long, otherwise it makes the final go too long. But I think 200 is okay.
Okay. You know, they're in this kneeling position. I've talked to some of the athletes about this before, and they said, you know, halfway through the final, sometimes their foot can go a little bit numb because they're sitting on it. You know, they're kneeling on that.
That is a problem, kneeling, yes.
Yeah, you know, during qualifications, you can get up and shake it off, I believe.
Yeah, you can. Yeah. You can get up any time you want, but in a final, you just can't get up and walk around. You just get a... Have no time.
And so you just have to deal with it. That's and ignore it.
Yeah.
So, you know, it looks like these women are just sitting there kneeling and shooting, but there's so much behind this, so much more than what the viewer who has never experienced this before knows about, you know?
Yeah, just for the people who don't know this sport, they don't realize what they're going to get a balanced position. You know, if you're not balanced, you're not going to be able to hold things still at all.
Mm-hmm.
And as you said earlier, you'd be... Your foot goes asleep, as you can see, the kneeling roll takes a bit of pressure off, but you still have a very numb and foot by the end of this. luckily, they're shooting prone after this, not standing.
That's true. So they do have a little bit of time to relax in that prone position. And at that point, they were even saying that sometimes your hand goes a little bit numb because you've been holding on, but you've got that 7 minutes of the changeover time.
7 minutes moving around, so it should relax you just a bit. Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah, prone, your hand can get a bit numb or fall asleep at times.
Well, you're one that would know that. You are the master of prone position.
Thank you. Yeah, sometimes I can fire a match or I can finish a match and it's fine. Other times... pain sometimes when you go to sleep. It's just yeah, slight change in position or something. But
and once we get into the prone position, we can take a look and see about the posture and how they are, and you can see the breathing, and you can see that when you should shoot, you know, it's between heartbeats or when your pulse is... Go into that a little bit more.
Yeah, pretty much between pulse beats, if you can feel your pulse beats. Sometimes you do, sometimes you don't, but obviously between breaths. But in the prone, you'll be able to almost see when a person, or pretty much guess when a person's going to fire a shot.
Right.
Which the viewers will be able to see when they change positions.
Okay. So wash... coming off that 10.2 with a 10.0. He's not looking very pleased with that result.
Yeah, dealing's one of those positions where I've noticed I shoot three position and everyone else will tell you around here that shoot very good three positions. That kneeling's a position of it works extremely well or it doesn't, and there's just nothing in between for some strange reason and no one knows why.
That is very strange, in fact.
Yeah.
And so you really just want it to work. You don't want to think about the other side.
You really want it to be working because even though it's a 45-shot final, you think, oh, maybe get away with one or two bad shots. But really, you can't. Every shot counts.
Right. In fact, you know, as we were saying before, look at that. Zuba sitting in the center there has got a perfect 10.9. That's a really great way to go.
Good-looking group, too. That's really good to see.
And in fact, we have got Zuba Singh in the lead by a point over Pejcic. Chang is in third place, 9/10 of a point behind. Westerheim, 2/10 of a point behind her, and everyone below are just tenths, like just a little hair of a point behind each one of them. You know, it's really anyone's game, like we were saying before, Warren. Someone could be super strong in the kneeling position, and then we go into the prone position, and everything changes around. So it's so early on in. Of course, you always want to start out really strong because you'd like to have that score carry on over.
Yeah,
if you're not
strong. Off very well.
Right.
52-2, I'd be happy to do it prone.
All right, let's focus in on Petra Zuba Singh. She's really gone leaps and bounds over the last few years.
Oh, she certainly has, yeah.
Starting off with a 9.6, she cannot let that get to her, but you can see she's really upset about that.
Yes, we're having a little bit of a lead she has. It just helps a bit.
On now to Pejcic.
She just seems to have been around forever.
She really has. Such an enjoyable woman to be around, too.
Oh, yeah. Just a lovely person. You know, easy to talk to. She's gives advice to people and asks.
Exactly.
She's really good like that, yeah.
And gives a lot of support to even, like, the pistol shooters. And
oh, she does,
it's really nice.
And doesn't matter what country you're from, she'll support you.
Exactly.
She's really good like that.
It's like a good string here for Chung. We still have 2 minutes and 15 seconds for this series, and we're moving on to the third one, the last one in the kneeling before they go into the prone. We've got Jason Parker, the U.S.
Very nice fellow, Jason.
Unbelievably nice. Yes, very, very. He's great. He'll sit with me and commentate every so often if he doesn't have somebody in the final, and is just a world full of knowledge.
Oh, yes, bit of a shame he's not shooting anymore because he's just a nice person and just used to see him at the range shooting. And I mentioned the other day about, what are you doing? So I'm not shooting. Oh, that's right.
It is strange to see the changeover sometimes and you say, wait a minute, you should be shooting right now.
Then,
no, not anymore. Okay, looks like Sowash is taking a breath there, trying to get back into it. Now to Yi, finishing up there and just waiting now for Sowash for her last shot. Unbelievable. Nice string there for Pejcic.
Yeah, good news here. 103.9, a lot of people be happy with that.
So some things have changed around now. We've got Pejcic in the lead by a point over Westerheim. Zuba Singh has now moved down into third place. She's only 2/10 of a point behind Westerheim. Chung is 3/10 of a point behind her and 1.2/10 of a point separating Sowash from Chung. You know, like we said before, this is, you know, very, very unusual to see Yi Siling in eighth place. But, you know, the kneeling just may not be her thing.
Just might
but once you get her in standing, look out.
Standing, I think she'll come forward, yeah.
Okay, this is the last series in the kneeling position, and then we'll be going into a 7-minute changeover in sighting time. And just to let you all know, that is a crucial time. It's only 7 minutes. It seems like a lot to maybe the viewers, 7 minutes, but they have to change over everything to make it work in the prone position. And to do that in a good amount of time, so then they have time to do their sighting shots. And sighting shots are pertinent, you say?
Oh, it is, yeah. You're trying to get your offer reconfigured and your pose adjusted for the prone position, then get in position. It's prone, so that's such a long way. It seems to take longer to get in position for prone, and then your sighting shots, so you're zeroed before they say start.
Exactly. And tell us, what will they be doing? What will they be changing around?
Obviously, the butt plate, if we have a butt plate, which can be higher. Sights, probably change their sights, move the hand stop a little bit. Sling maybe lengthened or shortened. Adjust straps on the jacket, so it'd be almost shooting like a new rifle again.
It's a lot.
It's a lot, yeah. Not as bad as when they go from prone to standing, a lot more changes again.
That's right. Luckily for them, they've got 2 extra minutes, so it's a 9-minute changeover in sighting time.
Plus, they've got to get all their gear organised, so it's just easy to grab, so saving, you know, the odd little seconds here and there.
And with all that said and done, then you got to calm down.
Yeah, calm down again, yes.
You know, you've got to let your heartbeat slow down a little bit, your pulse slow down a little bit, your breathing slow down quite a bit. Look at the Zubas thing, starting off with a 10.8, which is a 10.1, a 10.7.
Yeah, not that whole, really pretty.
A 9.8, that was kind of surprising there. And now on to Sowash. Sowash coming off that 10.4 with a 10.0. Westerheim finishing off with a 10.4. Paychich having another nice string there, keeping her in the lead. So let's take a look now. Before we're going to be going into the prone position, we have got Paychich holding on to first place by 1.2 tenths of a point over Zublesing, who has now moved up the scoreboard in second place. We have got Chung in third place, only 1/10 of a point, and on Zublesing's heels, Westerham in fourth place, 1.4 tenths of a point behind her. Yeseling has moved up the scoreboard. She's now in sixth place, and Ruskin is in eighth place. Still, you know, Warren, we can't really say too much about this because we're still so early into this final. We'll be going into the prone position, and I just ask you all to tune in just a couple minutes to watch what happens there. Welcome back to the Gabala Shooting Club here in the finals hall, where we have got the women's 3P event going on. We have moved it on over from the kneeling position, and we are now in the prone position. I'm here with Australia's 2008 Olympic Games bronze medalist Warren Potent. Warren, what do you think so far about this final?
So far, it was very close to start with. It's sort of the field spread out a little bit now, but with the prone, probably a great deal of changing. Hopefully it will be, make it more exciting. But yeah, I've got no idea who's going to be the top of the moment. But yes, It's spread out a bit, but hopefully after the pro-nil we'll get a bit closer again and make it a bit more exciting. But so far it's been a really good final.
It certainly has. Now they're in the prone position, and once again, the women shoot at three series of five shots, but this time they have 150 seconds per series. And 150 seconds is definitely enough, I would say, wouldn't you, Warren?
Oh, plenty of time for the prone,
yeah. We've got Pejcik on our screen right now. She is currently holding on to first place. We've got Zubusing on her heels and Chung in third place. Things can change around on a dime, as we know, from position to position. After the prone, we're going to be going into a 9-minute changeover and sighting time before we go into the standing position. And the standing position is where you see things really change. But let's not think about that right now. Let's just focus in on the prone.
Yeah, the girls were at this moment.
Pejcik starting off the 10.6, not a bad way to start. Now let's just talk a little bit, Warren, when we have a close-up of them face-on, like Zubusing, what's happening now? You know, obviously she's moving around quite a bit.
Yeah, just settling in position, it'll take a few breaths. Some people take two, some three, some more. Just basically settle your heart rate down, then you'll be on final aim, and you see a very, very good hold, very little pulse, if any, and when things feel right, the shot just goes off.
That's a 10.0 following that 10.4 for Zubusing. Nice, 10.6 for Chung.
Yeah, they're probably really looking at hopefully getting 10.5s and better, really. You can't ask much more there than 10.5s because Ralph Ammunition can't shoot much better than that. But yeah, if you get 10.4s and high, you're doing okay.
Now, if you're shooting in the 9 ring, that's going to cause you some problems.
Yeah,
isn't
it's going to cause you a problem in
right.
the final, yeah.
And we do see some shots here in the 9 ring. Also, here also for Ruskin starting off the 9.9.
Yeah, 9.9 just so close, but so far, really. But it's just, you know, probably just nerves or. Yeah, you know, sometimes you saw your eye gets a bit tired of your sighting, you're just not seeing it like you think you're seeing it, which can be a bit of an issue. Even though it's the most steady position, technically it's one of the most difficult because any differences in any stresses in your position of change will put your shot off as well. So.
This is kind of surprising here also from Yi, starting off in the 9 ring, finishing off in the 9 ring. We've got one more shot to go, and that's from Gauss. It's a beautiful, absolutely beautiful string for Sowash there.
Yes, that's a brutal looking group. Should be happy with that.
And in fact, she does have, that is amazing, 53.7.
That's really nice, huh?
We do still have Pejcik in the lead. She's only 3/10 of a head of Zubusing. Chung, only 3/10 of a point behind her. And Soash, with that 53.7, has now moved up into fourth place. She's only 9/10 of a point behind Chung. Two more series to go in the prone position. Then we'll be moving it on over to the standing position.
Yeah, the first four positions are very close at the moment.
What would be the highest? What were you looking for a group, a series of shots, would you say? I mean, Amy Sawash just did a 53.7.
I'd be happy with that.
You'd be happy with that.
53.7 would be really good, yeah. If okay. If they can finish around, let's say, 100 and, well, I think 200 and, just escapes me at the moment, yeah, about 250 really good score.
Okay. Now we're beginning to see some scores more in the 10 ring here. In fact, Westerheim starting off with a 10.9.
Nothing wrong with that.
That's lovely.
I'll look at a 10.9, just a couple of bonus points.
Ruskin, 10.7.
Yeah, about 150. You see about 155. You're really shooting well around here.
Points here over there, Ruskin. It's another element here in the finals hall that the athletes have not experienced before, really, and that is music's playing in the background.
No, it's a first.
It is, and I can't tell if it's a distraction to them more or if it is just that they're zoning everything out.
If they're zoned out, you know, probably it could be a distraction. I'm very lucky where I train in Sydney, the music's on all the time, so it's nothing. But when they're clapping, that's something new. Mm-hmm. The World Championships, the last shot that everyone started clapping, though, this is different. But you seem to get out of the back of your mind or just enjoy it as being part of it.
That's right. You know, you have to keep in mind, though, everybody has different likes and dislikes for music. So if you've got something playing that might be, you know, making you want to hang from the ceiling, that's not going to help you at all.
Yeah, it's true. You don't want it to be heavy metal or something, probably.
So Wash finishing off with a 10.1.
Still shooting good, 52.4 then. So, yeah, still firing very good.
Zubla Singh finishing off the 10.4 for that series. Got the Italian team here rooting her on. And let's just take a look. Pejcic is losing her great advantage. She's only ahead now by 1/10 of a point. Chung has now moved up the scoreboard into second place. Zubla Singh is now down into third, 4/10 of a point behind her. And Sowash is 6/10 of a point behind. Really, where we can see the cutoff edge here is between Westerheim and Yi. There's Yi, Gauss, and Ruskin in 6th, 7th, and 8th place. Things still can change around, but as you can see, we had quite a distance separating each one of them during the kneeling position, and now it's just 10ths of a point.
Yeah, it has up until 5th place, and 6th is 3 points behind, which sounds a long way, but in standing coming up after this next string, it's going to change all over again.
Okay. All right, let's focus in again on Sowash. It's a nice thing we've seen some of the shotgun shooters from the U.S. team that have come down here to cheer her on, which is really nice.
Yeah, it's good to see. Hopefully that's what they're doing, not just to keep warm.
Exactly.
But the Americans always has been a very close-knit team, I've noticed over the years.
I have, too. During the World Cup finals or when there's a combined World Cup, that they do go over to the shotgun range or come over to the finals hall and keep an eye on each other, which is really nice.
It's good to see, yeah. Yeah. It's a really good cohesive team. A lot of countries can learn from that, I think.
I think so, too. Again, on now to Pejcic. Yeah, she's been holding on to first place. This is exactly what we saw with Brin yesterday, holding on to first place between the kneeling and then also the prone, and then everything changed around in standing. But this is looking very, very good for Pejcic.
Yeah, she's quite a good standing shooter, so she's in a
very good
position.
Yeah, exactly.
Good string coming along with the chain.
Westerheim, also not bad. Not bad at all, finishing off the 10.9.
That one.
And there we go, in the nine ring for Sowash.
That would be very happy, that one.
No. We've got about 25 more seconds of this series and just one shot to go for about half of these athletes right now.
That's a better shot for us.
That's much better. Okay, things have changed around now. We have got Chung, who has now overtaken Pejcic, only by 1/10 of a point. Zubla Singh in third place, 4/10 of a point behind Pejcic. Westerheim is now in fourth place. She's almost a point behind Zubla Singh, and Sowash has now moved down the leaderboard into fifth place. She's a half point behind Westerheim. We're going to be moving it on over now to the standing after this 9-minute changeover and and sighting shots that are going to be taking place. Then we'll be moving on over to the standing. And in the standing position, the women are going to have 250 seconds for two series in the standings. And after the end of the second series, seventh and eighth place are going to be eliminated, and we'll be moving on to single shots. And there are five single shots that are shot in the standing position, and after each one of those shots, the woman with the lowest score will be eliminated until we get to the bronze, silver, and gold. So just stay tuned in and join Warren and I as we come back for the standing position. Welcome back to the finals hall, where we've gathered for the last series, or the last position in the 50-meter rifle three positions woman event. I'm Hillary Russell, and again, I have my pleasure to have Australia's 2008 Olympic Games bronze medalist Warren Poten here with me today. So Warren, it's been pretty exciting so far. We're now going into the standing position, and this is just two series of five shots. And after those two series, seventh and eighth place will be eliminated, and then we'll be going into single shots. And after each single shot, whoever is in last place will be eliminated. So it's really a crucial time for these women now.
Certainly is now, yeah. Time, at least the clock's winding down for them. It's been a very good final, been quite close right through.
It really has.
Towards the top. Yeah, now in the exciting part, the standing position, which is the one everyone loves to see.
And it's a tough one, you know, because they've already been in the kneeling. They've gone into the prone. Now they had a change over everything, calm their bodies down, get their pulse down, their breathing down, and now make it happen in standing.
Yeah, they've been going for over half an hour now, so obviously tiredness maybe starting to creep in with some of them, so it's a tough final. So it'll be good to see who what happens after first two strings, and yeah, the elimination after every shot. So the last five shots is really brutal. Everyone counts.
It really, really is. And it's Chung now, who at the last series in the prone position overtook Pejcic. She's only ahead by 0.1 of a point.
There's nothing in it now.
You know, Chung, who has had a really banner year. She won two silver medals during the World Cups, one in Beijing and one in Fort Benning this year. And so you got to take your hat off to her for that.
Yeah, for sure. You know, it's not been around very long. Here she's leading the final. So, yeah, hopefully be really exciting for her. She can be there in the last three shots. Well, last two shots, isn't it?
That's right. Pejcic starting off the 10.3. It was Chung with a 10.7. And as you were saying before, Warren, Pejcic is a very, very good shooter in a standing position.
She is, yeah. She's a good all-round shooter, really. She's just won a lot of medals in three position. And she just looks calm whenever she's doing it as well. She just doesn't seem upset or cranky after any shot. She just...
No, not at all. Nice. A 10.6. We have that 10.4 for Zublasing. Westerheim having a bit of a difficulty there. 9.4, 9.3. Followed by a 10.3. We've got about 2 minutes and 35 seconds left of this series before we go into the second series in the standing. Sowash is shooting in the 9 ring.
Yeah, in standing, doesn't take much to be out in the 9 ring either.
Not at all. That's nice.
That makes it a bit better.
That helps things out for Amy Sowash, 10.5. Get Martha Chung starting off with a beautiful 10.7. She's now back into the nine ring, and one more shot to go for Chung. Finishing off with 9.5. Gauss, who is currently in seventh place.
She's been so much time preparing for every shot for standing for everyone.
It's really amazing. You know, you see the difference between a lot of these women. We only have two, three women that haven't shot their last shot yet.
Yeah, just got under a minute, so there's still plenty of time for
them. Exactly. You've got all the time in the world here.
Yeah, just taking the time. But having said that, it was an indoor range. It makes it easier for them.
That's right. Yi finishing off the 9.8, and it's Sowash we're waiting for now. Zublasing finishing off with 51.7, the highest score.
Yeah, she's been very good standing shoes. Oh, yeah. Had a good year this year, 3P and air.
10.4 finishing off for Sowash. So things have changed around here. Warren, we've got Zublasing, who has climbed up the leaderboard. She's holding on to first by a half a point over Pejcic. Chang in third place now, 1.4 tenths of a point behind Pejcic. And it's Sowash, who is in fourth place, almost a point behind. Right now, we've got one more series of five shots to go. And then after that series, seventh and eighth place will be eliminated at this moment, but only at this moment. We have Yi and Ruskin holding on to seventh and eighth place.
Yeah, a spot you don't want to be right at the moment.
That's exactly not where you want to be, exactly.
But, Petra Zuppling has just come up and first, where she likes to be, where everyone likes to be, of course. Pejcic still top two, which I've got a feeling she'll probably finish there, but somewhere in the top two, I'm saying, not second.
Right, exactly. You know, we've got Ruskin here, who won the gold in Maribor this year. Looks like she's taking a little bit of time to get into the zone. Okay, starting off with a 10.2. And Yi starting off with a 10.6. This is Yi's up-and-coming event, a 10.8. Beautiful shooting there. Obviously, as we all know, Yi Siling is the top of the top when it comes to the standing position. We have Gauss now starting off with a 9.3, followed by a 9.6. Pejcic coming off an unfortunate 8.9 there.
Yeah, it's a bit out of character, so hopefully it won't hurt
really
too
is.
Much. Yeah. Standing, being like that can happen. Doesn't take much.
Now your finals hall in Australia, in Sydney, that is, if you're shooting at a 50 meter event, you're shooting outside, is that right?
Yeah.
I do remember that. I remember very well years ago when Jamie Byerly was still still shooting. And it was so windy, and she was standing there, and her body was just swaying back and forth.
Yeah,
and I thought, man, that poor girl.
It's a very difficult finals hall, that one, because they got just a small aperture, and the wind blows through very strong. It's one of the toughest finals halls around.
Westerheim putting off a 10.0. Ooh, with an 8.7. We're seeing some shots in the eight ring, Warren, and quite a few in the nine as well. Yeah.
Yeah, we go now for almost three parts an hour. It's a long final, so you probably plus there's five matches beforehand today. So
exactly.
Yeah, if you were starting to feel a bit tired, possibly. It's physically a very demanding final, this one.
It certainly is. Like you said, they just had the qualifications right before this, so they've been going at it for a while now.
Yeah, so if you end up being one of the two people to fire on the last shot, that's 95 shots you fired. Sorry, 105 shots you fired for the day, plus sighting shots, so it's a lot of work.
It's a lot of work, exactly. Chang finishing off with 51.0 for the series, and Zubla Singh with 50.
He just made it off a little bit closer now.
Last shot for Sowash, finishing off with a 9.4. Still keeps him in fourth place. But we're going to have to say goodbye to our eighth place athlete, and that will be representing Germany, Beate Gauss. And finishing off in seventh place, representing Germany as well, Eva Ruskin. It's too bad for Germany today, but you have to say, you know, they did their best to get in here, and it's just the best of the best that come here.
That's
so
right,
get a pat on the back for that.
They both made the final, so there's no harm in coming 7th and 8th in the final in this competition.
So we've got Zubla Singh holding on to first place by almost a point over Chung. Paychix just now in third place, 6/10 of a point. It's Yi in the hot seat. She is 1.5 points behind. That's going to be really hard to make up in one shot.
It's just going to be very tough. You know, anything can happen standing. I still think 1.5 points is too far. There's greater shot she's on the feet.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, the thing is with Yi Siling is everyone expects the best from her all the time.
They do,
you know? And this is a different event for her. It's not the one that she is, you know, she won the gold in the 10-meter air rifle woman, and that's what she's really known for.
She's
but you see her face, you just think that she's winning gold.
Yeah, that's it. It's used to her and gold. It all goes together all the time.
It's a lot of pressure to put on her, but it's a nice way to finish off with a
10.5. Here's your 10.5, yeah. But, you know, it's not a favourite event. You know, she knows that. I mean, she's just happy to be where she is. And she'll finish and give everyone a smile, as she usually does when she walks off the line.
So finishing off in sixth place, representing the People's Republic of China, we've got Yi Siling. All right, next shot is for fifth place, and I don't know who's going to do it. We've got Sowash only 1/10 of a point behind Westerheim.
That's the point one, that's nothing.
Yeah, point one is absolutely
nothing.
So let's just take a look here at Sowash and Westerheim and see who is going to be able to stay in the game. After that, it's kind of hard because they've got 2.2 of a point separating them from the next position.
It's going to be very tough for the next, whichever one of those to up the next shot.
They're going to need some serious, serious mistakes, and I don't see Paychik falling into that at all.
No. Petra Zubla Singh is sitting okay at 1.1 points ahead. It's not too far, but enough to be a little bit comfortable.
9.5 for Westerheim, and waiting now for Sowash, always the last one to shoot.
Here she takes the time, just making sure it's all going right.
And a 10.1.
That keeps her going.
Yeah, it'll keep her in the game.
Yeah.
So finishing off in fifth place, representing Norway, we have Malin Westerheim. Now, this is the hardest shot of the final, Warren. It is for fourth place, and I don't think anybody really wants to go home in fourth place.
No.
They want to go home with a medal.
She's just going to last that one more shot, but it's going to be very difficult for Amy Sowash at the moment.
I don't see how it can really be that she can stay in the game, let's say.
No, all she can do is just, you know, fire the best shot she can and probably hope, and we'll see what happens. In some ways, probably the most exciting shot, too.
Exactly, it really is. You know, Paychich now is 4/10 of a point behind Chung. And I know that she's hungry for this. I know that she's hungry for the gold. I'm not sure how. Wow, 10.4 is great for Paychich. Oh, Chung also 10.4. That's going to negate anything between. It seems like 10.4 is a catch.
10.4 is a pretty popular one here. So yes, it was at the end of Amy Sawatch, unfortunately, for her.
And still watching the shot with a 10-point
good shot
line.
To finish with.
No, that's a great way to finish
it
off.
It is. That was it. Did the best you could, but unfortunately the others didn't allow it to catch up.
And in fact, in fourth place, representing the United States of America, we've got Amy Sawash finishing off absolutely in style and with some class with a 10.9. Zuba Singh holding on to first place by 1.6 tenths of a point over Chung. We've got Pejic in third place, 4 tenths of a point behind. It's, I think it would have to be anybody's game now.
Anyone's
between
game.
Pejic and
yes,
Chung.
Yes, 0.4 is not much.
The next shot will decide bronze medal in this competition. For the next competition shot.
I have a feeling that Zuba Singh is not letting her guard down by any way, shape, or form.
No, she's got her head. She'll be staying there, I think.
Nine 9.7 for Chung and a 10.1. for Pejic.
Oh,
and it's
going
to be a shoot-off. Now, this is what we like to see here.
It makes it more fun.
It certainly does. It's going to be just the shot between Chung and Pejic. Obviously, Zuba Singh will not be a part of this.
It's amazing. 44 shots and you're dead equal on score.
And then you have to go into a shoot-off. You must say, what in the world? Just let me sit down for a minute. So this is a shot for the bronze between Pejic and Chung. The spectators and the crowds are certainly not making it any easier for the concentration level.
No, they're getting right into it, yeah.
And a 9.6.
Let's just have another shot. So neither of them want to go yet.
I think they just want to stick around here for a while, obviously.
Yeah. I haven't seen this for a long while. Two shots are still equal.
So one more shot to see what's going to happen here. I really thought for a second there that Pejic had it was going to lose it.
I thought so too, yeah.
You've got to be kidding me.
Another tight shot. That's amazing.
I don't think I've ever experienced this before, Warren, to be honest
with
you.
Not in standing. I've seen it prone once before in Beijing some years back, but never standing,
All right, if they both shoot a 10.9, so I think they should both
46 shots and they're still equal.
Very good fight.
Certainly
I have to say, Sheng Jing from the People's Republic of China, really great job finishing off with the bronze medal after a three-way shoot-off or a three-time shoot-off.
She's probably a bit upset after that, but still the bronze has got away with something, which is good.
That certainly is. And in fact, she has never won a World Cup final medal before, so the bronze is great.
Yeah, she'd be really happy with that.
And also, Pejic has never won a World Cup final medal before. All right, we've got 1.4 tenths of a point separating Zuba Singh from Pejic, and I do not see Zuba Singh putting her guard down by any means.
No, she's putting as good a shot she can. They're both 1.4, it's probably just too far to catch up.
Pejic with a 10.2. And 8.5, unbelievable, the last shot.
Anything can happen.
Unreal, everything has changed around. I wasn't expecting any of this for the bronze and silver and gold, to be honest with you.
No.
And there she is, our gold medalist on the very last shot. Unbelievable shooting going for Snezhana Pejic, representing Croatia. She gets it on the last shot. Really great shooting by Snežana Pejčić.
Yeah, it was an amazing final with a few surprises.
It really, really was. And our silver medalist today representing Italy, Petra Zubusing. We didn't really see that coming, did we, Warren?
No, we didn't, but yeah, sport being sport, anything can happen.
That's right. So listen, I wish you the best of luck for tomorrow, and hopefully the fog will be super, super thick so you can do your qualification rounds or your preparation and sighting time.
Yeah,
here in
I'm
the
hoping so too. It'll be somewhat warmer for me as well. Yeah, thank you very much. It's been a pleasure helping you again.
Once again, here are our finalists, gold medalists, Pejčić, silver, Zubusing, and Chung, our bronze medalists. Thank you again for joining us today, Warren.
It's been a pleasure.
And the gold medalist representing Croatia, Snežana Pejčić. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your support. That was an amazing competition, one of the best I've seen all year. Incredible. Thank you for the entertainment, to all the athletes for participating. We have two more finals today. We have the men's 50-meter pistol.